President Obama makes his case for your vote. In my exclusive interview, I ask the president about the issues that matter the most to Nebraskans and Iowans, like the cost of health care and jobs in the Midwest. So people who voted for you in 2008 but are saying, look, I haven't seen change in my life, will they see it in your next term?
Well, you know, what I promised was that I would wake up every single day working hard on behalf of middle-class families.
Good evening. I'm Brandi Peterson.
I'm Adrian Whitsett in for Rob McCartney. President Obama spoke to about 2,800 people this weekend in Sioux City, Iowa.
And right after, he talked to me one-on-one. Fittingly, he gave us 7 minutes to ask anything we wanted. We did not submit our questions in advance for approval, and we also followed up with reaction to what the president told us. Nebraska Governor Dave Heineman has been a vocal opponent to the Affordable Care Act, and he says, how are we going to pay for this? We're going to have to cut education or raise taxes. How do states pay for it?
Well, listen, I think it's maybe some misinformation on the part of the governor there. The states don't pay. The federal government pays. 100% of coverage for folks who don't have health insurance, we're giving them tax credits. And the benefits that we're providing extend to people who have health insurance. This isn't going to cost states, and you know, I think the challenge we have right now is just a little too much politics and not enough common sense.
Governor Heineman, a Republican, told me Sunday by phone states will pay 10% after the first 3 years, and he says that will cost taxpayers hundreds of millions of dollars. The president's visit here to Morningside College in Sioux City is one of several stops he's made in Iowa over the last couple of weeks. But what about Nebraska? We asked the president how much he plans to focus on that one possible electoral vote out of five in the Cornhusker state.
You're right. Nebraska's always leaned Republican. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, I've always had a good relationship with folks like Chuck Hagel, who was you know, we didn't agree on everything, but he's a good friend and actually is helping me now on a whole bunch of stuff dealing with national security. And so even if we don't end up winning Nebraska this time, my hope is that I can continue to have a great relationship and work well with all the elected officials, both federal and state and local in Nebraska.
Regarding the economy, you mentioned at your first stop in Council Bluffs that, look, change is going to take time and that your job isn't finished yet.
Right.
For Nebraskans and Iowans struggling to make it paycheck to paycheck, how long should they expect to wait, and why should they believe that in a second term you can do the job?
We have been working our way through this recovery process, creating 4.5 million new jobs, 500,000 new jobs in manufacturing, and the plan that I'll be putting forward at the convention on Thursday in Charlotte is going to talk about a vision for the future.
So people who voted for you in 2008 but are saying, look, I haven't seen change in my life, will they see it in your next term?
Well, you know, what I promised was that I would wake up every single day working hard on behalf of middle-class families and everybody who's willing to work hard to get into the middle class. And I'm confident that we've got every tool that we need to succeed, but what we can't do is go down the path that's being offered on the other side, which would essentially go back to the same policies that got us into this mess in the first place.
I was just one of two reporters the president granted one-on-one interviews with yesterday. The other was a station from Mason City, Iowa. You can watch more of my interview with President Obama on our website, KETV.com. Just look on our homepage.
We also reached out to Mitt Romney's campaign, but they did not provide a response. So we went to the Pottawatomie County Republican Party today. Co-chair Naomi Leinen says Iowans will vote for fiscal responsibility. She says that means voting for Romney.
I think more people who voted for Obama have seen that he hasn't fulfilled all of his promises, and they're wanting a change for someone who will.
Iowa is, of course, a battleground state, and the latest Rasmussen survey gives Romney a 2-point edge in the 11 swing states. His running mate, Paul Ryan, will be in Cedar Rapids Tuesday and Des Moines on Wednesday. And, of course, the Democratic National Convention starts tomorrow in Charlotte.